A thrilling stunt turns to terror when the bungee cord suddenly snaps and five jumpers are hurled into the water at over 60 miles an hour.
I didn't have a heartbeat. I wasn't breathing.
It was a leap of faith that became a real life or death rescue.
For Norville, when the rigged equipment with only minutes to get it done before the cops moved in. And it was all caught on tape. Stacy Sweet has our exclusive look.
One.
I go, ladies and gentlemen, count of three, we go.
Two.
We're at the base of the Skyway Bridge right now.
I don't even know what was going around me. All I wanted to do was just jump and get it over with.
Three, go.
It's called pendulum jumping. And on Sunday, April 27th at 7.02 p.m., four men and one woman attached themselves to a single bungee cord and jumped off the Tampa Bay Bridge. It was a jump that went terribly wrong.
Let's go! Let's go!
Instead of a nicely smooth, orchestrated move, it became a jumbled mass of arms, legs, heads, torsos.
As the jumpers began their upswing, their bungee cord suddenly gave out.
When it snapped, I turned from front to back, and all I saw was the heads and of my friends and legs skipping on the water. And then we all just sank. And it was just a nightmare.
Keep breathing!
The freakish mishap was all caught on tape by a local film crew. But freelance cameraman Bob South never imagined that in an instant, his role would change from photographer to rescuer.
Come on, cameraman, come on.
They were screaming at us, please help us, get us out of the water. And I thought, we've got two dead people floating around in the water.
The Skyway Bridge stands more than 200 feet high. The group had planned to swing like a pendulum from the bridge, but their thrill quickly turned into terror as they came crashing down 60 feet, 60 miles per hour, into these Tampa Bay waters.
We're out there.
Get me over there.
Did you think you were dead?
I thought I was gonna die.
In fact, 26-year-old Jeff Sargent and another jumper, 30-year-old Lori Martin, came extremely close. Sargent says he only remembers hitting the water like a ton of bricks. His seemingly lifeless body floated face down and unconscious in the water.
I didn't have a heartbeat. I wasn't breathing. They had to revive me in the boat.
Come on, Johnson. Come on, Sarge.
But ironically, this Airborne Express employee from Limerick, Maine, wasn't even supposed to make the risky leap that day. In the moments just before the jump, someone pulled out, and Jeff Sargent was in. This was his first stunt ever.
I feel bad that we all got hurt and we almost all lost our lives. But then again, it was such a once-in-a-lifetime thing that I couldn't pass it up.
Amazingly, one of the jumpers, Ken Bunker, was uninjured. The other four suffered varying injuries from broken bones and bruises to the broken neck sustained by Lori Martin.
You're all right. Go!
One man who's used to death-defying stunts is group leader Steve Trotter. Trotter made a name for himself when he went down Niagara Falls in a barrel in 1985 and again in 1995. Steve has also made similar bungee leaps off some of the most well-known bridges in the country, like San Francisco's Golden Gate.
Can you still stand there today, broken ribs, a neck brace, blood in your lungs, and say, it's the thrill?
I wasn't supposed to get injured. That wasn't a thrill. The stunt didn't go off as planned. But the bridge, the Golden Gate Bridge was a thrill. The Newport Bridge was a thrill. All the other bridges are thrills. You know, this bridge was a nightmare.
Have you gotten a chance to see your friends?
48 hours after defying death, Steve and Jeff returned to take one last look at the bridge and recall a jump they both say they'll never attempt again.
Seeing this bridge this morning, do you see it a whole lot differently?
Like I said, I treat it with respect. I'll never be back here again. I couldn't care about that bridge anymore. I love to look at it. I'm never going to jump off it again, ever.
I'm Gail King. Have you ever heard of car surfing? How about the game Open Chest? Or maybe if you live in a city, you've heard of subway surfing or even elevator jumping. Now, chances are you have never heard of any of these so-called games. I never heard of them until the producer, Paul, told me about them last week. But the reality is some of your children are playing them. Now, all of these games have two things in common. They are games teenagers from all over the country are playing, and they are games that have all